A very good day to all of you. Today, you will learn about a new menu. But before that, let us revise what we learned in the previous class. Do you know what is the full form of PDF? The full form of PDF is Portable Document Format. Why do we make a PDF file? If we want that other users of our file should not be able to make any changes to our file, we change our file to PDF format. What is the difference in save and save as? If we want to see our file sometime later, then we can use save or save as. By using save, we can save our file on the computer at any location and with any name that we want to give for our file. When required, we can later open our file and use it. Using the Save As option, we can see our saved file's name and location, and if we like, we can change both the name and the location. Now, all of you, power on your computers and open the writer file. So, have you been able to open your writer files or not? If you are not able to open the writer file, then you must watch the video and learn from it. You can open the writer file in many ways. Today, you will learn a new method of opening the writer document. This method is the shortcut command method. To open a file with a shortcut command, you must know the command for that opening. So, first of all, you need to keep your left hand, one finger, on the Windows key, which is shown in the video, and press the R key. A box opens, which is the run box. In this, you have to, without giving any spaces, type out SWRITER. SWRITER. And then take the cursor or the pointer to the OK button and click on OK. Your writer document will open. Today, you will learn about the edit menu. So, let us take a look at all that you will be learning today. The things you will learn today are undo, redo, cut, copy, paste, select all, and find and replace. Type out the paragraph being shown here. Have you typed out the paragraph? Alright, now let us start learning about the sub-menus of edit. First, we shall learn about undo. Do you know why we use the undo? By using the undo, you can remove any work one after the other that you had done on your page. For example, you can remove a word or even a picture. You can use the undo in two ways, from the edit menu or by using the shortcut command. The shortcut command for this is Ctrl plus Z. Let us learn how we use undo by watching this video. With the help of this video, we will now learn how to use the undo command. For doing this, you have to take your cursor to the edit menu. Take the cursor or the pointer to the edit menu. Left click on that. And you will notice a box opens. Select the undo option and left click on that. You will notice that the last line which we had typed earlier gets erased. Now if you want to erase this once again, you can use the edit menu, or you can also use the control plus Z, which is the shortcut for this. In the video, control plus Z has been used, and you notice that twice the lines have got erased. Now let us once again use the from the edit menu. So select that, go to the undo, and you'll notice one more line gets erased. Once again, we go to edit, select the undo, click on that, and one more line gets erased. This way you can continue to keep erasing the last line that you had typed earlier. Let us now learn how to do redo. Do you know why we use redo? Redo is just the opposite of undo. This means that whatever text or pictures you remove by doing undo, you can bring them back with the help of the redo command. Redo can also be used in two ways, from the edit menu or by using the shortcut command control plus Y. Let us watch the video and understand why we use redo. Let us watch this video to learn how we can do redo. Redo is the exact opposite of undo. In the previous time, you had erased all the lines by doing undo. To do redo, bring your pointer or the cursor to the edit option, click on that, and then select the redo option. As soon as you click there, the last line that you had erased comes back. Again, go to edit, select the redo option, click there, the next line reappears. One more time, select the redo option from the edit menu, and the next line appears. If you want to use the shortcut command, which is control plus Y for redo, you have to do it here, and the next line reappears. To use the shortcut command, press the control button with your left hand, one finger, and then press the Y button, and you can see in the video, the next line reappears. You can keep using the from the edit menu and redo option to bring the lines back. Let us now learn about the cut submenu. Can you say why we use the cut submenu? We use the cut submenu to remove any text or line from a place, and we may even use it to remove the text or line from one place and paste it at another place. We can use the cut submenu in two ways, from the edit menu or by using the shortcut command control plus X. Let us now learn about paste. Can you say why we use paste? The paste command is used with copy or cut. When we use cut, we are just removing a word from its place. So when we need to bring that word to a new place, we will use paste. You can use paste in two ways, from the edit menu or by using the shortcut command control plus V. It is important to remember that when we want to perform a cut, we need to select the desired text so that the computer knows that we are wanting to cut that selected text. Let us see what happens when we use cut in this video. Let us now watch this video and learn how cut and paste are used. To be able to cut a portion of the text or the paragraph, you need to first select the portion, the line or the text or the paragraph that you want to cut. So to do that, you can use any of the methods, either with your mouse or the touchpad, or with the shift key and the arrow keys. As is being shown in the video, we select the last three lines of this paragraph. because we want to do a cut on this. Now take your pointer or the cursor to the edit menu as is being shown in the video and click on that with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad. A box opens and you have to look for the cut option and click on that. As soon as you click on that, this paragraph gets erased. Now let us see how we can bring back that paragraph by doing paste. So to do a paste, you can do a paste at any point where the cursor is on your writer file. Go to the edit menu, click on that, and then click on the paste option. You can also use the shortcut command Ctrl plus V to paste. So you see where the cursor was at that point, the paragraph gets pasted. Once you have cut the portion, you can paste it many times. So you, again, if you paste, the next line comes. So you can use the shortcut command Ctrl plus V as is being shown in the video, and you can do the paste a multiple number of times. Let us next learn to use the copy submenu. Do you know why we use copy? We need to use copy when we have to write any text, line or paragraph more than once in our document. We will need to use copy and then use paste to reproduce it at different places in our document. Remember that with cut or copy, we will be using paste very often. Using copy, we can just copy a given text, and to bring it onto our page, we need to use paste. Copy can also be done in two ways, from the edit menu or by using the shortcut command Ctrl plus C. To use copy on a desired line, paragraph or text, you need to select the text. This video will show us what happens when we use copy and explains why we use it. Let us now watch this video and understand how copy is used. So, to copy any text, line or paragraph, you need to first select the paragraph. You can select it using the mouse or touchpad or the shift arrow and the arrow keys. So, once you have selected the paragraph, as is being shown in the video, you can do copy either through the shortcut command or through the edit menu. So go take your cursor to the edit in the menu bar to the edit option, click there and then click on the copy option. The shortcut command for copy is Ctrl plus C. Once you copy, no effect will be seen, but it has been copied. Now place the cursor where you want to copy the text once again, as is being shown in the video. And again, paste can be done in two methods, by using the shortcut command or by using the edit menu from the menu bar. So take the pointer or the cursor to the edit option and select the paste option. The shortcut command is Ctrl plus V. So you can now, once it has been copied, you can paste many number of times that you want. So you keep the cursor and use Ctrl plus V for as the shortcut command for paste. So this is how copy and paste are used. Let us now learn about select all. Can you say why we use select all? By using select all, we can select the entire paragraph or the whole page in one go. This option can also be used in two ways, from the edit menu or by using the shortcut command Ctrl plus A. This video will show us what happens when we use Select All and explains why we use it. With this video, we will learn how we can use Select All option. So to select all, again you can use the shortcut command Ctrl plus A, or you can do it from the edit menu. Select all will select the entire line or paragraph that you are interested in. To do select all, you have to take the pointer or the cursor to the edit menu of the menu bar and then look for the select all option. Click on that and you will notice that your entire paragraph or the line that you wanted has got selected. You need to select the line or the paragraph to be able to do any formatting on that. Without selection, you cannot do any formatting. So this is how you will use select all option. Next, we will learn about find and replace. Can you say what happens when we use find? By using find, we can search our document for any text or word. Note that you can only find a word or text which appears in your document and the spelling should be correct. Can you tell why we use replace? By using replace, while doing a search, we can search for any word or text in our document and replace the same with any other word or text. Find and replace can also be used in two ways, from the edit menu or by using the shortcut command Ctrl plus F. Let us now watch this video and learn the usage of find and replace. In this video, we will now learn how to do find and replace. In order to find any text, any word in your text or paragraph or line, you need to be able to look for that word and it should be correctly spelled. And it should be available in the text. So to find, you go to the edit menu and click on find and replace option. A box opens and you can see that you can type in the word that you are looking for or that you want to search for. And it also allows you to replace that word with another word of your choice. So to search for a word, you should type it correctly and in the correct spelling. Once you have typed the word, there are two options. One is to find, which will find the first time that this word appears in the text. Or if you click on find all, then that same word, it will find all the words of that spelling which appear in the text. Like it is being shown in the video, we have searched for the word day and all the words with that spelling T-H-E-Y have been highlighted or have got selected. Similarly, if you want to replace this word with another word of your choice, you can do it with the shortcut command. Or you can do it through the edit menu. So you go to the edit menu and click on it and then look for find and replace. Remember, the shortcut command is Ctrl plus F. Again, that window will open which is for find and replace. Now you can type the text that you want to replace the word T-H-E-Y, any word that you have searched for, and you want to replace it with a new word. So let us say that the new word for us is Pranav, P-R-A-N-A-V. So we type the word here and if we click on replace, then it will replace the first time that the word they occurs. But if we click on replace all, it will replace all the words which had appeared when we searched for they. So now when you see in your text, the word THEY has been replaced by the word of our choice, Pranav, at all the places where they had appeared. So this is how you can use find and replace. Since we will be ending today's class now, all of you should close your writer file, and if you have a doubt about closing the file, you must watch the video and learn. In order to close the writer file, you will use the same method as you have learned for closing the paint file. So take your pointer or the cursor to the top right corner where there is a cross sign and click on that with the mouse or the touchpad using the left button. You see three options appearing in a window. Since you do not want to save right now, you can say discard, which is the middle option. Click on that with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad, and your file, writer file, gets closed. Next, shut down the computer properly. In today's lesson, you have all learned about undo, redo, cut, copy, paste, and find and replace. Thank you.